Welcome to the Sky Sea channel, which always discusses everything about the sea. Today, I have a question for you. Have you ever seen the sea turn red? No, I'm not talking about a scene from a horror movie or a biblical miracle. I'm talking about a real phenomenon that happens in some parts of the world, the Red Sea phenomenon. The Red Sea phenomenon is when the surface of the sea changes color from blue to red or brownish red. It looks like someone spilled a giant bucket of paint or blood into the water. It's both beautiful and terrifying at the same time. But what causes this strange phenomenon and what does it mean for the environment? The Red Sea phenomenon is caused by algal blooms, which are massive growths of algae that occur along coastal regions. Algae are microscopic organisms that live in water and produce oxygen through photosynthesis. They are usually invisible to the naked eye, but sometimes they multiply so fast that they form visible patches or clouds on the water. Algal blooms can happen when there are favorable conditions for algae to grow rapidly, such as warm water temperature, abundant sunlight, and high nutrient levels. These nutrients can come from natural sources, such as upwelling of deep water or runoff from land, or from human activities, such as sewage discharge or fertilizer use. However, not all algal blooms are harmless or beneficial for the ecosystem. Some algae species that cause algal blooms produce toxins that can harm marine life and humans. These algae are called harmful algal blooms or red tides. Red tides can kill fish, shellfish, mammals, and birds by affecting their nervous system or suffocating them. They can also cause skin irritation, respiratory problems, and gastrointestinal illness in humans who come into contact with contaminated water or seafood. For example, in 2018, a massive red tide event occurred in Florida, killing more than 200 tons of fish, dozens of dolphins, hundreds of sea turtles, and thousands of birds. It also affected millions of people who suffered from coughing, sneezing, and eye irritation due to the exposure to algal toxins in the air. The red tide lasted for more than a year and costed more than $8 million in cleanup efforts. On the other hand, some algae species that cause algal blooms are harmless or even beneficial for the ecosystem. For example, some algae can provide food for zooplankton and fish, or create habitats for other organisms. Some algae can also produce bioluminescence, which is a natural light emission that creates a beautiful blue-green glow on the water at night. Bioluminescence is a phenomenon that occurs when living organisms produce light through chemical reactions. Some algae species can produce bioluminescence when they are disturbed by waves, currents, or other stimuli. This creates a dazzling display of light that can be seen from the shore or from boats. Bioluminescence can also attract or repel predators, communicate with other organisms, or help with navigation. The Red Sea phenomenon is not a new occurrence. It has been recorded throughout history and across different cultures. For example, some people believe that the biblical story of Moses parting the Red Sea was actually a description of a red tide event. However, with the increasing human population and activities along the coastlines, the frequency and intensity of algal blooms have also increased in recent years. According to a report by UNESCO, more than 60% of coastal waters have experienced an increase in eutrophication, which is an excessive enrichment of nutrients that stimulates algal growth. This has led to more than 500 HAB events per year worldwide, affecting more than 150 species of fish and shellfish, and causing economic losses of up to $2 billion per year. The Red Sea phenomenon is a fascinating but also alarming sign of how nature and human activities interact. It shows us the beauty and diversity of life in the sea, but also the potential threats and consequences of disrupting the balance of the ecosystem. As responsible citizens of this planet, we should be aware of the causes and effects of algal blooms and take actions to prevent and reduce them. I think we should all do our part to protect our oceans, such as reducing our water pollution, conserving our water resources, and supporting the research and management of algal blooms. If you liked it, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to Sky Sea channel for more interesting topics about the sea. Thank you for watching this video. And see you next time.